I hope to see, and I had a start again, with just my friends and family. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and I can't take that away. Hey, and I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas to the sea of shining sea. From Detroit down to Houston, New York to LA, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time to stand and say, hey. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Thank you, Jesus. We have full rights to your kingdom. Thank you for everything you do for us, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. We honor you today, Lord Jesus.
In the holy holies, behind a heavy veil, set the Ark of the Covenant, where the Most High dwell. And only the high priest could enter therein to offer a sacrifice for atonement of sin. But the veil was rent in an instant, revealing that holy place. For on a hill nearby, on a rugged cross, justice met grace. Now I can go into the Holy of Holies. I can kneel, petitions know, I can go into the Holy of Holies. And although I'm just a common man, because of God's redemption plan, I can boldly approach the throne. The blood of sacrifices is no more required. For the blood of Christ, the spotless lamb, completely paid the price. In the sacrifice of worship, we'll open heaven's door, allowing us to enter in the presence of the Lord. Now I can go into the Holy of Holies. I can kneel and make my petitions known. I can boldly approach the throne.
Hallelujah. We can all go. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for making a way for us.
I God's redemption plan, I can boldly approach.
Good morning.
Yeah, put on your red shoes and dance. Okay, let me open up in prayer, and then we'll go ahead and get started. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for this day. Lord, thank you for your worship that went forward this morning, Father God. And one of the songs said, Father God, that we will surrender our all, Father God. That we would give our lives away, Father God. Oh, Lord, let that be so true of every heart and mind in this place today, Father. Holy Spirit, I believe, Father, that you're going to do something supernatural in this house. Lord, may we be ready to receive what you're wanting to do in our hearts and in our lives this morning, Father God. Lord, we've been praying for revival, Father God. Well, Lord, I'll be the first to say, Lord, let it start with me, Father God. Lord, let it begin in this house, Father God. Lord, let it spread throughout the community, Father God. Lord, let it spread throughout the nation and let it spread throughout the world, Father God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we need a fresh touch, Father God, this morning. Lord, we come hungry, Lord, and your word says that those that are hungry and thirsty for righteousness, they shall be filled. Not might be filled, but they shall be filled, Father God. So we're praying, Father God, that you just satisfy this hunger, Father God, even if it's just a little bit, Father God, even if it's just a tiny little bit, Father God. Lord, we know that you are able to meet the need, Father God. So have your way, Holy Spirit. Move mightily, Holy Spirit. Lord, we don't want to be the same, Father God. We want to leave this place changed by your word. Amen. On fire by the Holy Spirit, Father. Yes. That we can leave this place and we can go out, Lord. And let your light so shine that men will see your good works working in us and begin to glorify you, Lord. That we'll go out and be soul winners, Father God. That we'll tell people about Jesus, Father God. Even if it's not verbal, maybe it may be a smile, it may be a kindness, but whatever we do, Lord, may we reflect your kingdom in this dark, dark world, Father. I'm thanking you in advance, Father God, for what you're going to do in us and through us, Father God. We ask these things now. In Jesus' name, and all God's people say, amen. Amen, amen, amen. Good morning, good morning, good morning. I was so disappointed last Sunday when the rains came, and I couldn't get up in here. But that's all right, because the rain came today, amen, the rain of the Holy Ghost, amen. And I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, and I hope you are as well. Well, Papa Rick, if you put that first picture up on the board. Again, we've been talking about a new year, a new ear, and a new heart. Amen? And we've been talking about revival. We've been talking about the history of revivals and great awakenings because you know what? We need a move of God, y'all. We need the supernatural invading the earth, y'all. But the thing about it is, are we really hungry for that? See, what I love about, you know, when I hear Pastor Bob or when I hear other people teach or even when myself teach, see, it's your hunger that pulls on the anointing, church. Did y'all hear what I said? It's that hunger. And if you come hungry, ready to receive a word from the King and his King, be filled. Amen. Hallelujah. So we began to start talking about, again, revival. We began to talk about the different parables and we talked about education and how important education is. But one of the parables that I sat on was the parable of the soils. Go ahead with that next one, Papa Rick. And there are different kinds of soils that Jesus talked about. He talked about the one that was by the roadside. And we talked about this and how when the Father spreads the word over the roadside, it just remains there. It doesn't do anything because our hearts are cold and our hearts are hard and we didn't come ready to receive the word. That's the wayside. And then we talked about the rocky road. Oh, man, and we'll get a little bit more into this. And how the word just springs up, but there's no functional root system. So every time the word is sown, it may pop up quickly. It may pop up with joy, but there's nothing underneath that. There's nothing there to catch the nourishment of the truth. Hallelujah. And we need truth. That's how we survive, church. That's how we thrive in the kingdom, is based on the truth, amen, of the word. And then we're going to talk a little bit today about the thorns and when Jesus sown his seed among the thorns. And then we're going to talk about the good soil. Amen. So let's go ahead and get into it. So my first question is, do you come ready not only to hear the word, but do you come ready to hold on to the word? Now, let me read a little something right here. And Lord, me and these glasses, I tell you, I love them, but my goodness, I can't stand them at the same time. Now, watch this. See, the devil is a sworn enemy to us profiting by the word. And the best friend that he has in the church is one who does not take heed to the word. Instead of thinking about the words that are coming out the man of or the woman of God's mouth, your mind is elsewhere. So here it is. The faithful farmer is sowing the seed, but because you're not coming ready to hear truth, you're not come ready to receive truth, all it does is just lie there. Not germinating, not doing anything. The seed is just there. And I told y'all last week, see, you can't say that it's Farmer Bob's fault that when Farmer Bob sows the seed, you don't get anything out of it. And it's not Farmer Willie's fault or Farmer Michelle or whoever's up here farming and throwing the seed out there. See, if you're not receiving it, it's not our fault. It's your responsibility, church, to do something with your seed. Amen. Tell everybody, I got the seed. Come on, I got the seed. Get the seed and do something with it. See, it's all right to have the seed. I got the seed, but what's the seed doing inside of you? What are you doing with your seed every time this word is sown forth in your heart, in your mind, in your life? What are you doing with your seed? You just can't, I mean, that's fine. You got the seed. I'm great. I'm happy. I'm elated about that. But if it's not doing anything, it's just seed. Amen? Hallelujah. So it's your responsibility, church. It is your responsibility. And watch this. See, we just can't come into the house, and I said this before, and I'm trying to move quickly. We said this before. Church can't just be a putting on and a putting off. You put on your Christian face when you're ready, but then you take it off when you're not ready. You put it on here, and you take it off there. That is not Christianity, church. You can't take a plant and keep pulling it in and out the ground, and you expect it to do something. You expect your Christian life to grow, but you keep pulling it out the soil. You keep pulling it up. You don't let it do anything. You just let it do whatever it wanted to do. It's not doing anything. So therefore, you can't complain if you're putting on and putting off. Amen. Come on now. We're talking about real church, y'all. We're talking about real Christianity, y'all. We're talking about a real move of God. And that move of God starts with you and I individually. Then when we come together corporately, as we're praising the Lord, as we're worshiping the Lord, because we did our due diligence all week long by our Bible studies and doing the things that we're supposed to be doing, then when we come up here, a Holy Ghost explosion takes place. The Don't shout me down now. Come on now. A Holy Ghost explosion takes place, or is supposed to take place, when the people of God come together. But if the word is continued to be sown and your heart is not open to it and your ears are not open to it and you're just not open, there's nothing God can't do, y'all. What do you expect him to do with that? He's making every effort in this last hour. But I believe, Pastor, a time is coming and God's going to say, enough is enough. I got to move on. And how sad Jesus was when he came to his people and they missed the day of their visitation. Don't let this word just pass you by. Don't be frivolous and fruitless with the word. Amen. Amen. Come on, church. Amen.
Amen.
Because God wants to do something. God desires to do something. Watch this. See, it's easy when you're on the wayside road and God is sowing his seed. See, it's easy to be a passive listener. Watch this. A passive listener is easy prey to Satan. And guess who Satan is? Excuse me. Satan is the robber of the word. He's a murderer of souls. Amen. He's the great thief of sermons. Amen. And if you don't come prepared by doing your due diligence before you get here, watch this. The birds of hell are coming to take your miracle seed. God is trying to get the seed to you. He's trying to get the miracle to you. He's trying to get the word in you. But because you're not listening, the birds of hell just come and immediately take that word. And as they take in your word, now they're taking your miracle. They're taking your healing. They're taking your mind. They're taking your hopes. And watch this. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Not only do they take, but when they take, they're going to leave something behind. Because when they take your courage in the Lord, they're going to leave behind some fear. Oh, you hear me, church, this morning. You hear me this morning, church. See, he going to take, but he's going to leave something behind. Maybe in some of us, he's leaving worry behind. Maybe in some of us, he's leaving doubt behind. Maybe in some of us, he's leaving all kinds of turmoil in our minds or in our body. But the enemy is leaving something behind. But you had an opportunity to take the word. You had an opportunity to do something with the word, but you just let it by the wayside. Come on, church, this is real right here. I'm feeling this. I'm feeling this, church. I'm feeling this thing, church. Hallelujah. Okay, now we move on to the stony ground. And we talked a little bit about the stony ground. Amen. And we were saying some profound things, but I want to expound on that a little bit more. See, with the stony ground, unless our righteousness exceeds that of the scribes and the Pharisees who thought that their displaying of the truth of God. See, they thought that they were displaying the truth of God, and they thought that their truth was the Magna Carta or the hinge of their spiritual root system. But God said something completely different. Y'all are all off. You are completely off. You're not displaying God, because all you're displaying is ritualism. You're showy. You're more about outward driven. And while you're being outward driven, you're showing. But when God began to peer into their hearts by preaching of the word into their hearts, and you looked up under there, and there was no functional spiritual root system. Somebody better say amen. And we cannot let that be of us, church. Here it is. God is doing all he can. Man, God is so good, y'all. He's doing all he can to put this word in your heart, to put this word in your mind. And yeah, you gladly receive it. And we come happy, ready to receive it. And then the thing just begins to shoot up. But watch this. It's shooting up, but ain't nothing shooting down. Nothing's growing underneath. But again, a bunch of hard rocks. Maybe Sunday morning, church should be called the Hard Rock Cafe. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I didn't even thought about that. That just hit me. Word. That's good, Lord. I like that. Welcome to the Hard Rock Cafe, you know, where all the hard rocks hang out, you know. And I know it's funny, but at the same time, it's almost serious. It could be kind of serious too, amen? Yeah. Especially when, okay, the word is here and it's not doing anything, but then we come hearing the word, and I don't want to get ahead of myself, and there's still no progress, amen? Amen? Amen. You getting something out of this morning, church? Come on now. Y'all ride with me. Y'all ride with me now. Ride with me. Okay. See, God's criteria of how we look and see and do things isn't the same as how we see and do and think about things. Ain't that right, Mom? Ain't that the truth? See, the thing is, and I see it all the time, we're always trying to reduce God down to our size. You can't contain God. You can't do nothing with God. He is too big. You need to come on up. But the way to come on up is to get on down by humbling yourself before the Lord. And then the word says, and then in due season, he will what? He will lift you up. Amen. So if you want to be lifted up in the word, not only just be lifted up, but have a grounded, good spiritual root system, then we have to begin to humble ourselves. But a hard rock ain't going to humble himself. All the hard rock going to do is hear the word and say, amen, praise the Lord, God bless you. And then that's all you're seeing right there. And the word ain't even taking no root. Let this word take root in your hearts and in your minds. You got to work it. The word will work if you work the word. Do I need to say that again? The word will work if you work the word. Come on, everybody. The word will work if you work the word. Somebody give God a hand clap. Come on now. Isn't that real true? Whew. Isn't that the truth? Amen. Okay. Now watch this. As we're talking about the stones, okay? It says right here that they are quick in hearing, amen, and they're even quicker to receive it. And when they receive it, they receive it with joy. But watch this. And let's be real. All of us, in some form or fashion, we get excited. We want to hear a good word. We want to hear a good sermon, amen. But watch this. But are you profiting from what you hear? See, the word, you were pleased with the word, but yet you were not changed or ruled by the word. See, watch this. Oh, this is good. Watch this. See, oh, this is good. This is good. See, watch this. Listen real carefully now. See, the heart may melt under the word, but watch this. But your heart wasn't melted down by the word. Woo! Come on now. Y'all hearing what I'm saying? Did y'all hear what I just said? See, the word may come and your heart might just get a little melt, a little, I felt that. But the word did not melt your heart. Why? Because the Lord, when he melts your heart, God wants to mold and shape your heart. Is your heart pliable to the word of God? Amen. Can God get your heart and can he mold it and can he shape it? And if he got to smash it again and then pick it back up and then mold it and then shape it and then he got to smash it down again and then mold it and shape it. Is your heart pliable to the word of God? Somebody better say amen. Amen. Whew. Boy, y'all got me huffing and puffing this morning. Whew. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Okay, watch this now. Watch this. So when I read the brother and he was talking about a heart that should be molded, watch this. I think it's the Hebrew word for it is awnag, A-W-N-A-G. And what that means is soft or moldable. Amen. Watch the scripture. Woo! They got me huffing and puffing this morning, brother Span. Woo! Amen. Watch this. It says, delight thyself. See, also another word for moldable or pliable is also delight. So watch this. So be moldable, or let thyself be moldable in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart. Amen. Watch it now. But the meek shall inherit the earth, and watch this, and shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace. So every time I come to God, every time I receive the word, every time I hear the word, I'm allowing it to do what it do. So just like, Lord, you're I'm the clay and you're the potter, so do what you got to do. Word, do what you're supposed to do. Take my heart, take my mind, mold it and shape it so that I can be more like you. Amen. Hallelujah. And that's what he wants. Amen, church. That's why you have to have a heart ready to be molded and shaped by the word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's the truth right there, folks. That is the truth. So watch this. So we got to be pliable, church. We got to be pliable. Amen? Okay, now watch this. So here's the thing. They may hear the word and gladly receive the word. And watch this. They may endure for a while. But when the times of testing come and when the time of pressure come, they may be able to last for a little while. They may be able to remain. But watch this. Eventually, they're not going to bear any fruit. You're not going to bear any fruit because you have no depth of earth from which to draw the moisture. Watch this. And when the pressure and the time and the testing come, guess what? You are scorched and withered by the heat from the sun. Hallelujah. You're scorched because you have nothing to draw the moisture. You're not drawing anything from the word. Again, you have no spiritual root system. And thank you that I spoke with Pastor before I did this. Amen. But watch this. But when the fire comes, and when the heat comes, all you're going to do is just get burned and scorched and look brown. You look dead. You look dry. Thank you. The Lord told me to make sure I told y'all this morning. Thank you. Watch this. So there was a point in time where I was just cruising along doing my thing. And then times of testing came. Oh, I thought I would have been able to handle the times of testing and the pressure and the trials and the tribulations that came against me. But in fact, I actually did the opposite, because obviously I thought my root system was deep enough into the word where if I said, man, Lord, if you bring something my way, I got them. But instead of flourishing, instead of having fruit in my life, I actually got burnt and I became withered and dry, and that's where my beginnings of isolation began to come in. That's where the beginnings of fear began to come in. That's where the beginning of hopelessness came into me, because I had no depth of spiritual root system. And I dried up. And I closed myself in. Y'all heard me tell the story. And I said, God said, man, boy, he looking dry. Boy, he looking dead. And the enemy said, yeah, he is. It's over. It's over, Willie. You'll never live again. You'll never smile again, son. I got you. Oh, we're going to throw a party in your name. All the demons of hell are shouting. All the demons of hell are smiling. All the demons of hell are having a good time. Talking about we killed them. We got them. We got them. And Jesus said, wait a minute. Wait a minute, devil. I've sown some good seed into that boy. That boy have sprung up some good fruit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He ain't going nowhere. He might look a little dry now, devil. He might look a little crunchy right now. And his root system is all messed up down there. But I got a plan. I got a plan. Hallelujah. That's why you ought to take courage, because God got a plan. Amen. The word says that which he started, he will finish. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, it's not, I don't know about y'all, but for me, oh, it's not fun being in this place, Pastor. Oh, it's not a fun place to be. And oh my goodness, the Lord just kept sowing. He kept putting that seed. He kept putting that good seed on that boy. He said, you're going to live again and you shall not die. You're going to live again and you shall not die. I know you're looking a little hard right now. I know you're looking a little sad right now. I know you're lost and confused, son. I know you don't understand, Father God. Son, you don't understand the betrayal, but Papa does. I got you, son. I got you, son. But you just keep letting me put the word on it. Keep letting me put the word on it. Keep letting me put the word on it. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You see, we can endure for a while, but fruit needs to be cultivated from the seed. Because if you have no shoot, or if you just had a shoot, just an appearance of growth, but no depth, then you will continue to be a dry soul. We got a lot of dry souls, unfortunately, in the house, don't we, Ma? I'm not saying that. That's just a general statement. But if it's real, it's real. If it's there, it's there. Amen. Hallelujah. And how many of us, we believe that we got a shoot, and it appears to be, I appear to be growing, but really you're scorched, you're withered, and you're dry. You got to answer that between you and the Holy Ghost, church. That's a real question that we need to ask ourselves. Where are we? Again, with the excitement, yes, we all come ready. Oh, the word, thank you for the word, the word, the word. Oh, God bless you for the word, the word, the word. Oh, Pastor Bob, you preached a great word, word, word. But what's the word doing in your life? Is the word becoming a kingdom reality within your heart? Is the King and his kingdom word coming down, manifesting, and allowing the, thank you, Holy Ghost, the kingdom to establish itself in your life, amen? Amen. Can somebody get me a tissue, please? Thank you, brother. Bless you, man. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Because that's the truth, guys. I'm going to tell you, I've been here. Michelle, Willie, you coming to church? I ain't coming to that doggone church. Oh, come on, man, when you're coming to church. I mean, I never said this to her, but I'm just in my mind, you know. I ain't going to that doggone church. And you can't make me go to church. I ain't going. Oh, come on, Willie, just at least come on a movie night or something like that and just come get you something to eat, something to eat. What'd you say, eat? Well, maybe I could come on and come to movie night. So see, I done moved from the hard rock. Still a little rocky, still a little hard, but I'm here. We're here, amen. The progression of the word, amen. Hallelujah. Thank God for the progression of the word. Pastor, can you have that microphone to Rachel, please, since she's the closest? And can you turn up there to Colossians chapter 2, verse 6 and 7? Colossians chapter 2, verse 6 and 7. Please, are y'all getting something out of this? Yes. Is this helping? Okay. Yes. Colossians chapter 2, verse 6 and 7. And when you're there, Miss Rachel, you can go ahead and read, please.
And now, just as you have therefore received Christ, even Jesus the Lord,
right,
so walk, regulate your lives, and conduct yourselves in union with and conformity to him.
Hold. So, watch this. So, if the word is growing in my life, then a good plant cannot grow apart from good soil. So therefore, me as a plant being embedded, am I okay? Being embedded in the soil of the word, then I become in union with that word. Y'all see what the scripture says? Because it says, see, you can't receive Christ. And if you receive Christ, then you got to walk and regulate and conduct yourselves in union and in conformity with who? With who? Okay, with him. That's right. But it says, be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. But we can't be conformed to the ways of this world. And we can't pick the two either. I can't just pick the world one day and then I'm going to regulate my life in the world. And then now I'm here and now I want to regulate my life in the word. A plant can't grow in two pots. You're either in one pot or the other. If you're calling yourself a Christian, then remain in the King's pot. But if you want to be a worldly Christian, then just say, hey, I'm just a worldly Christian. That's just the way it is. And that's just the way I, you see? But isn't this the word now? I'm preaching the word. This is the word. That you have to regulate your lives and conduct yourself in union with and conformity to him. Verse 7, please. Amen. Verse 7.
Have the what, church? Roots.
Okay, go ahead, my sister.
Of your being firmly,
right,
and deeply planted,
right,
in him.
Right.
Fixed and founded in him,
mm-hmm,
being continually built up in him,
right,
becoming increasingly more confirmed and established in the faith,
right,
just as you were taught,
uh-huh,
and abounding and overflowing in it with thanksgiving.
But first it says, first you got to have the roots of your being. So the thing of the, here's the question, is your being firmly rooted in the word? Come on now. Look, let's look at it. It says first, in order, see, that's what it says. See, you can't just receive the word and then hear the word and then it spring up if your roots are not firmly and deeply planted first. Yeah. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on now. Not only firmly and deeply planted in him, but you got to be fixed and founded in him. See, sometimes I wonder, people think that, you know, like, let's say people like the Benny Hins and the Jakes and all these guys, they're just people just like us. Hallelujah. But what they did was, is they made sure that their roots were planted apart from what they do. See, their roots weren't growing deep by what they preached. The preaching came as a result of what they were planted in, and that nourishment and that root system began to grow them, and therefore now they're at the platform and at the stage of their life where they are. Amen. We can't do it apart from the root system. So that's why this is a danger right here for Christians. That's a danger because you're not even hearing anything, and as soon as you hear it, it's gone. But here you're hearing, and you're like, oh, praise the Lord, hallelujah. And now it begins to spring up, but there is no root system. You're not firmly fixed into anything. You're not deeply planted anything. All you are is just whatever that is, that is. Some Christians are happy with that. Because you've been, thank you, Holy Ghost, because you've been in such a mode of having this in your life, now you done become comfortable. You don't put in the work to go deeper. You're fine with surface Christianity. You're fine with surface type faith. You're fine with surface type praise. Thank you, Holy Ghost. You're fine with surface type worship. Hallelujah. You're fine with surface type healing. But that's not the depth of it. Touch your neighbor and say, go deep. Come on, touch your neighbor and say, go deep. Hallelujah. And watch this. And see, once your roots are firmly planted, then it says, watch this. And then you will be continually built up in him and becoming increasingly more and more confirmed and established in the faith. Come on, in the
faith.
So if you want your faith to be concerned and established, then you have to get rooted. And then once you okay. Check 1, 2. Okay. No. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so once you get rooted, hallelujah, somebody gonna have to grab a microphone, one of you gals, please. So once you get rooted, then you will be firmly and deeply planted, and then you will begin to be built up, and you become increasingly more confirmed. And when watch this. How, thank you, Holy Ghost. Oh, watch this, church. Isn't it how beautiful it is when a father confirms a son? Oh, what a beautiful thing. And when the father confirms the son, son, you're a man. Son, I'm proud of you. Son, I love you. Watch this. You're not going to see a son that's confirmed walking around like this, like he ain't got no hope, like he ain't got no confidence. Like he doesn't have anything going for him. But once the father confirms, he'll walk with his head high. He'll walk with his chest stuck out. And too many times, we got too many Christians walking around like this, walking with their head down, walking with their back sloped over, bent over, walking as if you're not even confirmed, because that's because you refuse to establish yourself in the word. You refuse to be built up in the word. You refuse to be confirmed in the word. And that's why you're bent over, and that's why your life is bent over, and you still might have it going on, because pastor said, I've seen many of people rich, I see many of people with a car, I see many people with big houses, but they're still walking around and their spirits slumped over. You might have it going on, but you might be slumped over in your spirit, and that's why you need the word to confirm you. That's why you need the father to confirm you. Hallelujah. That's why you need truth to confirm you and establish you, so when you walk with your chest. You walk with your head high. You walk with a smile on your face like I do. Amen. And that's because you're confirmed in the word. Amen. That's because the truth is doing what it's supposed to do within you. Amen. It's supposed to get you up, not get you down. It's supposed to make you smile, not make you frown. It's supposed to make you happy and glad and say, glory to God. I have the word. I have Jesus. I have the Holy Spirit. I got angels all around me. I might not have $1 million. I might not have a big car. I might not have a big house, but I got that which is important. I got God. I got God. I got God. Like pastor said, it's all God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo. Glory to God. I'm sorry. I just got to laugh for joy. That's the joy of the Lord. Amen. It's my strength. Amen. Hallelujah. So that's why the word is so important. Because it says, here it is, the last piece. Just as you were taught. You can't say that you haven't been taught, church. You can't say there hasn't been no good teaching that has come from this platform. Amen. The word's been going forth, amen. The teaching has been going forth, amen. But it says, just as you were taught, abounding and what? Overflowing in it with what? Thanksgiving. Oh, I'm so grateful this morning, church. I'm so grateful to be alive this morning, church. Oh, I'm so grateful to be out of that dark place, Miss Rachel. I'm so grateful to be out of that hole, Ma. I'm so grateful to be smiling, Ma. I'm so grateful to be happy, Papa. I'm so grateful. I'm grateful. I don't know about you, but I'm grateful. I'm thankful. I'm thankful. I'm thankful. Amen. Hallelujah. Be grateful. Be thankful. We're living in America, for God's sake. Amen. Hallelujah. We're living in a free country. We can still come and worship how we want to worship. We can still come do what we want to do. Hallelujah. I thank God and I'm thankful. I thank God for putting thankfulness in me. Amen. Hallelujah. That's why I can smile. I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. And his eye is on this little black sparrow. And all of these multicolored sparrows. And I know he's watching me, amen. Hallelujah. Can we take it deeper? Here we go, here we go, here we go, here we go. Now watch this. If we just rest on the hearing of the word, this will allow excitement, and there's nothing wrong with excitement, but heaven will never invade your life because it takes more than hearing. Apply the word. Apply the word, then faith will grow. Apply the word, then faith will come. And that's where the resources of growth comes from. It extends from your faith. Y'all seen the word, amen? Boy, and I got so excited I got off track. I'm just like a La La Land right now. I'm like, woo, Lord. Lord, you done blessed me. Lord, I can just put the mic down and I'm good, you know. Woo, this is so good. This is so good. I'm being blessed because faith comes by hearing and hearing the what? The word. So I'm hearing what I'm saying, so I'm being blessed by it. Amen. 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 That's how it works. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, so let me get back. Okay, let's see, where are we? Okay, so if you have no a root system, watch this. That means that you have no settled or fixed principles in which to make proper judgments. Did y'all hear that? If you don't have no word, you don't have no settled, fixed set of principles in which to judge on, to judge clearly. See, you have no firm resolution in your will, nor will you have any rooted habits in your affection, and nothing will be sap or strength because you have no profession. You're not going to speak what you ain't doing. If you're speaking it, then if you speak the word, then we just say faith comes by hearing and hearing the word. So if you want your faith to increase, you got to make sure you're hearing the word. That's the sap that runs throughout the tree, that runs through up the branches and spreads throughout the vines and all that and all the other stuff that comes with it. Amen. So sometimes we just need to tap the sap. Amen. Tap the sap. I think it's pretty, isn't that pretty simple? My likes that. You know, that's what we got. That's what we got to do. That's what we got to do. Okay. Now watch this. Can you turn to Revelation chapter 22, verse 16? And Miss Rachel, you read that for me, please. Revelation chapter 22, verse 16. Is everybody getting something out of this? Everybody good? Okay. Okay. Go ahead, Miss Rachel.
I, Jesus, have sent my messenger, an angel, to you to witness and to give you assurance of these things for the churches, the assemblies. I am the root, the source, and the offspring of David, the radiant and brilliant morning star.
So Jesus is the what? The root and the? The what? The root and the source. Everybody, the root and the source. Root, and he is your source. Some people just treat him like a resource, but he's not your resource. He is your source. And the word is your root. And you get your resource from the root and not from any other source. If you're getting your resources from any other source, then you need to change sources. Because you're tapping into the wrong root. See, the enemy would bring all kinds of sources and disguise them as a resource. But that resource ain't your source. You just jumped out of your real source and you just took a fake, phony resource and made it your source. And because we have no word, and when, watch this, and when times of testing come, and you, Lord, you know I need the money, and Lord, you know the bills got to get paid, but watch this, but and God says, I got you, but the word says, I shall supply all your needs. You don't need no other need, you just need the real need, the source, the root, and therefore, watch this, so the enemy now, he done got you all sprung up on the word, oh yeah, I believe. And then watch this. When it really comes to your faith, your real faith shining through, the Lord's going to pierce under there. Look at it. Ain't nothing up under there. You know, that's how they say it in the country. There's no root system. But yet, you're calling this resource your source. Thinking that this is going to bear you the fruit that you were looking for. But all you did is you just shoved me out. You just closed the door on me. You done shut the word out. So now when you're going to get burned. You're going to get burned. Watch it. You're going to get burned. Oh, it may not be now. It may not be tomorrow. It may not be down the line. But you're going to get burned because you done made something else your resource. When Jesus says that I'm the source, I'm the root, and not all your fake resources. Get back to the source. Rely on your source. Close the doors to any kind of resource that might appear to be a source. And what? Oh, hallelujah. Look how the Lord done bless me. Look how the Lord done hook me up. Look what the Lord done did for me. And yet the Holy Spirit is just piercing up under there. Dang. I can't do nothing with that. I can't do nothing with that. Nothing I can do with that. Because you done took your eye off the source. You don't put it on your fake resource. Watch it. Times are wrapping up, y'all. Put your eye on the source. Better get depth in that root. Amen. He is the root and he is the source. Amen. Okay, I'm going to leave that alone. I'm going to just let that, y'all let that marinate. Hallelujah. Don't be mad at me now. Come on now. Don't get mad at me now. I'm just preaching the word. Okay, so. What we need to do by faith is be united to Christ, who is our root, and derive all from him and depend upon him. Yeah, we got to do our part. Men, we got to do our part. I understand that. Do your part. But then let your part be part of another part. Amen? He's your part. And then he becomes your part. And now you can bless your partner. Amen. Did y'all get that? Boy, that stuff is just be coming from. Amen. Glory to God. Boy, that wasn't in my notes. Amen. 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 Okay. Watch this. Can you turn to Rick up there? 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 12. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 12. Y'all getting something out of this? Is this good church? Come on now. I'm preaching my little heart out up here. Amen. Amen. Glory to God, though. All glory to go to God. Okay. All right. Here we go.
Beloved, do not be amazed and bewildered at the fiery ordeal which is taking place to test your quality. As though something strange, unusual, and alien to you and your position were befalling you.
Okay, so watch this. So if you say you are who you say you are, then there's a test that's coming to see how much you qualify in that which you're speaking. Come on now, because it says, the word says that when the trials come, don't be bewildered, because the fiery ordeal is going to come, but it's going to test your quality, the quality of the word that is inside you, amen? So if the word comes and it springs up and you're seeing the shoot, but there's no root, then when the times of testing come, watch this, you're not going to qualify and make it. The quality of your faith or that what you're believing for is not going to make it, folks. So where are you in the testing process? Hallelujah. Because times of testing are coming, and they're coming. They're coming, but they're really coming. Because there's a lot, even though whether you're for him or against him, I'm not talking about whether you're for or against the president. That's not my issue. But what I'm seeing is I'm seeing a lot of stuff going down. A lot of people that are for and a lot of people that are against. And that mindset was already kind of rebelliousness was already settling on this country greatly. But watch the increase of it now. Watch the increase. I'm speaking prophetically. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Watch the increase of rebellion. And see, this is, thank you, Holy Ghost. See, this is why we got to make sure we get into the word. Thank you, Holy Ghost. So that any hint of that rebellion will not creep within us. And there's a lot of rebellion in the church. Oh, I had a study on that one, Pastor, but I'm not even going to go there. I want to stay focused. But we got to watch the rebellion in our hearts. That is a total affront that I've been studying to God when it comes to rebellion. But I'm not here to talk about that, but I'm just saying, what is the quality of your walk with God? We can't be so quick to say, because see, these are all the ones that said it real quick. But then when you begin to look up under there, nothing. Come on, church. Can we be real now? This ain't about condemnation, church. This is about growth. This is about kingdom. If you say that you're a kingdom person and you want to see God move in a kingdom kind of way, it starts right here. This is where it starts. Oh, Lord, I know it's getting late. It's getting late. Man, Pastor, I do. I try. I know we didn't get to the, but obviously maybe the Lord just wanted me to stay stuck right there. I don't know. Can I have two more minutes? Can I have a couple more minutes? Okay, now let's read. Can you turn to 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 7? 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 7. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 7, please. Whew. Thank you, Papa Rick. Okay, Miss Rachel.
So that the genuineness of your faith may be tested, your faith, which is infinitely more precious than the perishable gold, which is tested and purified by fire. Mm. This proving of your faith is intended to redound to your praise and glory and honor when Jesus Christ, the Messiah, the Anointed One, is revealed.
Amen. So, not only are you going to be tested, but through the test, you're going to see the real genuineness of your faith. See, when my faith was tested, Pastor. I would hear the word, I gladly received it, I thought, boom, I'm good. But then the genuineness of who I really was showed. Because see, when you melt gold down, all the impurities will come straight to the top. And as we're being tested in this, more impurities will come to the top. Now, sometimes we think testing could be a bad thing, but some of the testings could appear to be a good thing. I'll give an example. So I'm walking down the street, and I walk up on this sister, and man, hey, what's up? How you doing? What's your name? Oh, well, cool. Well, you know, what you? Oh no, don't tell me you cook fried chicken. Oh, this girl done got me now. She cooked fried chicken. All right, I'm coming over. That's cool. I mean, I'll come. I'll eat. You know, everything's appearing like it's a good thing, especially the chicken, you know. But, okay, well, girl, well, thank you for the meal. I appreciate it. Now, you know, now I got to go. Oh, what you want me to stay? You want me to spend the night? Oh, you just want to watch some movies and chill? Well, you know, what y'all say, church? What y'all think? Man, I tell y'all, not only she got fried chicken, but she got homemade pecan pie. Now, I don't know if you can do it like Miss Shirley, but boy, you got it coming close. So look, you got to stay for the pie, baby. You got to stay for the piece of pie. Well, can I have it to go box, please? You got one of them to go box? All right, come on now. See, that thing appeared to be a good thing. That wasn't a hot, fiery truck. Well, it might have been hot and fiery, but I wasn't getting burned by it. Amen. I wasn't going to get burned by that fire. So I went through the fire. Amen. So sometimes, watch this. We'll pull it back and I'm going to end it. So sometimes we got to be careful of that which appears to look good, but got a darkness behind it. Amen. We got to watch out for it. Because watch this. If we open that door to darkness, then that darkness would lead us into rebellion. And rebellion means that I'm not going to be rooted in planet, which is witchcraft. Boy, I really want to. I'm going to teach that one of these days. I'm doing some studying on it now. Woo! We're going to work on that. But to be continued for another time. Amen. When we come back, whenever Pastor lets me again, we'll finally get to the thorns and we'll get to the good, but obviously the good soil, but obviously Holy Spirit wanted me to hang right there. But let's take a little time. Let's not rush, because I really felt that the Holy Spirit was in this place. Hallelujah. And just humor me, but because Pastor said something that I thought was good. I got this from you. I got this straight off of you, Pastor. This is Pastor Bob right here. He said, sometimes, because I talked about when we sow seed, sometimes we have to take a rake to clear away all the rocks and all the debris. Let this right here, right now, church, be a time where we seriously, let's just hold on for just a couple more minutes, but let's be real about it and see what's in your heart and begin to rake away the debris. And Pastor said, this is straight Pastor, he said, one of the ways that we can rake away the debris is through repentance. When we repent, we're raking away the debris. So, seriously, church, because we're talking about the next level of glory coming into this. And it's not about Willie Tillman. It's not just because I'm here. When we're all in agreement, when we're all on the same page, when we all have repented like the word says, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves. So let's take some time. Papa, put some music on. Let's seriously humble ourselves. And if somebody needs prayer, come up here and get it. Don't quench the Holy Ghost if he's moving in your life because of your pride or your arrogance or your little secrets. Don't miss this time. We all got stuff. We all got little secrets that need to be raked away. We all got a little hardness of heart. that need to be raked away. Bitterness that need to be raked away. Fear. Maybe somebody might need some healing. So let the Lord. Come on. Come on, church. This ain't for us. This is for the next group that's going to come in here with us. But it starts with us. Amen. It's going to start with us. It has nothing to do with Willie Tillman. I'm just a voice. He's the ventriloquist. I'm just a little puppet. Amen. So with every head bow and every eye closed, come on. I know it's old school. I know they don't hardly do this kind of thing anymore, but we need to make sure, hallelujah, that we're in the right this morning. Come on now. Let's let the Holy Spirit do that Holy Ghost raking this morning. Clear the debris this morning, church. Come on, hallelujah. Clear the debris. Let Him clear your hearts. Let Him clear your minds. Be not deceived, God. Thank you, Holy Ghost. God is not mocked, for whatever a man sows, that he shall reap. If you got debris, come on, man. Come on, sir. Come on, ma'am. Put down your pride. Put down your arrogance, because watch this. Come on. Come on. Come on. I know there's more than this. I sense it in my spirit. I know it in my spirit. I know it in my spirit. We ought to be flooding the altars, church. We ought to be flooding the altar, church. You letting your pride get in the way. You letting your arrogance get in the way. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't put Him off any longer. Don't put Him off anymore. He'll forgive you. And so will I. So will Papa. Hallelujah. There's forgiveness in this house, church. There's healing moving in this house. I'm telling you, church, and I normally don't say these kind of things because I just don't. I respect it. I respect the presence of God. I respect His presence. If there's something that needs to be said or done, let's deal with it so we can move on for the next group. So we can move on for the lost soul. We can move, thank you, Holy Ghost, so that we can move on for the prostitute, that we can move on for the pimp, that we can move on for the drug addict. We can move on from the lost businessman, or we can move on for the lost businesswoman out there. There's a lot of people out here that are not saved. How about the athletes? Amen. How about the colleges that are in this town? Amen. Hallelujah. What about the gamblers? What about all the other things that are going on in this city? There are people who are here that are in need to hear a word, church. And we got to make sure this house is in order. Hallelujah. Bless you. Bless you, Lord. Real revival. Kingdom revival. Kingdom revival. I'll put it this way. You're just dealing with the man, but what happens if God really stepped His foot up in this house and the power of God really came in this house? He's going to do the revealing anyways. And the Holy Spirit is here and wanting to do the revealing. But if God really showed up, God is here. I'm not saying He's not. But if the glory of God was to come, we'll all be on our faces. I'm willing, church. I'm willing, I'm willing, I'm willing, I'm willing, I'm willing, church. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Hallelujah. This is the season, church. This is the season. Now is the time to seize the moment. We got to seize the moment. We got to seize our moments. Now is the time, church. Now is the time, church. I'm not trying to pressure you. I'm not trying to force you to get up here. You can sit right there if you want. That's no problem. But let the Lord deal with you. Hallelujah. And let's leave this place clean. Let's leave this place repentant. Hallelujah. We said we surrender all. Have we really? Have we really surrendered everything, church? Everything. Everything. I was watching something last night, and the man said that there's a price to stardom. Well, there's a price to the kingdom. And it first starts off with obedience. It first starts off with obedience. It first starts off with obedience. Hallelujah, church. It starts off with our obedience. It starts off with our obedience, church. God, thank you, Holy Ghost. God says, I prefer obedience over sacrifice. I prefer obedience over your sacrifice. Hallelujah. We got to obey. We got to obey. We got to get away from this pop stuff that goes on within the churches. We have to obey the word of God. We have to obey our master in chief. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, the Holy Spirit is here. I'm not lying about it. The Holy Spirit is here, church. Oh, I can feel the power of God. I can feel the presence of God. Hallelujah. He loves us so much. He loves us so much, church. He loves you so much. He loves you. He died for you. Hallelujah. That's how much He loves you. All He asks is that you obey. You obey. You obey. It's simple. Just obey. Close off those doors that lead to greater or further darkness, and obey the truth and walk in the light as He is in the light. Hallelujah. Just walk in the light as He is in the light. This is not a game. This is not a joke. This is serious. Kingdom business is serious business. We have fun, we joke, we laugh, we do all of those things, and it's time. But when it comes down to really getting to it, this is serious business, church. Serious business. Hallelujah. God wants to do something great in this house, church. I believe there's greatness destined for this house. For 7 years, the men of God have prayed for revival. For 7 years, church, the men of God have prayed for revival in this house. And now, here's our opportunity. Here is our opportunity, church. Here is our opportunity, hallelujah. Glory to God. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. Orabakaya, bless my brother. Orabakaya, rabokurabasha. Hallelujah. Bless my brother, Lord. You see his heart, Lord. You see his heart. You see his heart, Lord. Touch him, Lord. Touch him, Lord. Touch him.